Congress for Student Showcase, one of our most enjoyable part of the evening.
Well, are you ready to be amazed? And welcome, Board members, thank you very much for being here at Kenwood.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wells. I'm going to spend just a second. We started the leader meeting process 2 years ago. Mrs. Cordray lit that fire, and we've taken it and run with it. And so we're starting year three this summer. We're looking to devise a leadership council. A little differently than what we typically see in a student council. So I asked Mr. Arledge, being a K-12 teacher, if he would take on that project, and he gladly accepted it. And when we sent out applications, we were expecting 10 to 15 students to get involved, and we've been consistently over 80 to 85 students in our council. So I'm going to invite Mr. Arledge to tell a little about student council, and then most importantly, allow our student leaders to share information. So we're really focused on that board role of leadership tonight.
Excellent. Thank you, Mr. Morris, and welcome, Mr. Arledge.
Thank you, Mr. Morris. First of all, I want to thank you all for allowing us to share about student council this evening. Just quick information about me. My name is Matt Arledge, and this is my second year teaching at Kenwood Station, my second year as a teacher. And as Mr. Morris said, I started this as a K-12 project last year. And last year was just really researching, surveying students, surveying parents, surveying teachers about what they would like to see out of a leadership council for students. And this year we actually started the council. Myself and Mr. Baby were the co-chairs of the council. And we went through an application process. We went through a process of just sharing with students about what it's going to be about. And then we just went forward with it. I'm not really here, though, to share about student council. My students are here. Student members of student council are the ones I really want you to hear for about student council. So we're actually going to start with a quick video from Claire Lindemeyer, who was our student council president. She was unable to be here this evening, so she wanted to share a video with you all really quickly.
Thank you.
Twice a month first year. We have five different committees, including school improvement, school beautification, student and teacher support, school organized activities, and community support and involvement.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hi, my name is Emily Bailey, and I'm in Ms. Harmon's fifth grade class. The purpose of student council is to simply improve the experience of being a student, teacher, or staff member at Kenwood. Here the students learn about leadership and how to be a leader, and they are able to take on special responsibilities. Some examples are we held a school-wide book drive, we had morning readers, we assisted in special class settings, we helped teachers, administrators, office workers, and custodians in a variety of ways. So these are just a few of the helpful gestures and comments.
Thank you, Magnolia.
I am Joshua Head, and I am a fifth grader in Ms. Allen's class. Once we have joined student council, we have to select the leaders. The leaders are the president and vice president, secretary, treasurer, and committee chairs. The president and vice president are specially selected through an application to fill out. Mr. Arledge and Mr. Beatty read the applications and select the top five students to go to say a speech in front of student council. Student council votes and the top two. The top two say another speech for third, fourth, and fifth grade. Those grades vote and then they will have the president and vice president. The other leadership positions, the secretary, treasurer, and committee chairs, are chosen especially by Mr. Beatty and Mr. Arledge based on the students' leadership skills.
Good job.
On the next slide, I have one of their presentations they gave, one of their speeches they gave, but for the sake of time, I'm going to leave this with you all to look at another time and just move on to the next.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Arledge.
Staff and teachers throughout the year. This was called Star Staff of the Week,
It was not only to spotlight certain staff, but to also help the students learn more about the teachers. Community support and involvement. Throughout the year, this committee has done many things. One thing that is still going on is how the committee has helped support the teachers of students with special needs. We read, played games, and developed friendships with these students that we do not usually get to interact with. We also hope to create a positive environment for all students by greeting them in the mornings at arrival with encouraging words, posters, and cards. We even made and passed out rainbow bracelets to students that seemed like they needed something to smile about. Our goal has been to help students come to school every day happy and ready to learn.
Great.
I am the Vice President of Student Council, and I would like to talk to you about what a typical student council meeting looks like. A typical student council meets every Monday, every other Monday, from 2:20 to 4. In student council, we have five committees that have certain roles. If you were a kid walking past the library, you would see posters, markers, crayons, and you'd hear voices of teamwork, and kids would be going down the halls, interviewing teachers, and cleaning the school. At the beginning, or at the end of the meeting, we watch an inspirational video that teaches us how to be a better person. We discuss this video and how it follows the Leader in Me concepts and the Seven Habits.
Class. This year in Student Council, we have learned quite a bit about being leaders and following the Seven Habits. In Student Council and in our school, we believe that being a leader is more than just being in a place of authority or controlling the situation. We believe it is taking a stand, helping the people who need help, staying on top of your tasks, staying focused, being part of a team and not against it, going above and beyond, and being an excellent example. I've seen everyone in Student Council be leaders. Everyone has contributed and has come up with an idea or has helped make something happen. Everyone has gone above and beyond, working not just to finish something, but to make it as best as they could. It amazes me to see how much 70, 80 kids can get done when they have the support from each other and the teachers. Another thing that shows leadership is when we use the Seven Habits. Every meeting I see members using the Seven Habits. We are proactive by staying on task, even when adults are not around. We begin with the end in mind by thoroughly planning our projects. We put first things first by deciding how we are going to get things done, and then taking steps from there. We think with the end by compromising. We seek first to understand, and then to be understood by talking to each other instead of arguing. We synergize by working together to get things done. And we sharpen the saw by having a fun time when we do the projects. At the beginning of the year, I thought that the Seven Habits was some gibberish that teachers like to talk about just to annoy me.
I hope you all heard that.
But throughout the year, and especially during Student Council, I realized that they were life skills that we would probably always use. They can help you almost anywhere. They can help me in my first job or in college. They help me when I was writing this. I think everyone in Student Council feels the same way. Student Council is great and fun and helps the school, but I think learning leadership is the most important reason why it is good for the school.
Excellent. Thank you.
Hello. My name is Dane Larson, and I'm in Ms. Allen's fifth grade class. I'm also the treasurer of Kenwood Station Student Council. It has been quite the year for me, teachers getting me ready for middle school and trying to reach my goal to get into advanced math in South Oldham. But one thing I could always fall back on was Student Council. Right from the start, I could see this as a success. Mr. Arledge had come into our room and I filled out the paper and turned it in the very next day. The presidential competition then began. Unfortunately, I tied for third place, and I was chosen to be treasurer, and here I am. I almost feel like a person that has started something that was made to be amazing, sort of like Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, or even Alexander Graham Bell. This school will have big changes, and I know it. This next year, student council will be a blast and will bring even bigger and better changes to student council. Kenwood Station. Student council is very important to Kenwood Station because many people think the kids should have a say or opinion about what goes on around the school. In the Declaration of Independence, it clearly states we the people, not we the adults or we the staff. Kids who are in the school 7 hours a day know best of all what they enjoy and dislike about the school. In all of the committees, people come to the meetings to have their opinions heard. We have started from nothing and transferred it into a year of fun and changes.
Dane, you are going to be one of the reasons this school sees big changes next year. I also look forward to seeing you working on the Board of Education in Oldham County someday soon.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm going to tell you about Reese Loggerblade.
Reese, welcome.
And I'm going to tell you about the honor of being in student council. One of the many honors of volunteering for student council is the fact that each student council member is trusted to develop ideas or programs that help improve the school environment. The faculty and administrators give us the privilege to make sound decisions that affect the entire student body. Each and every student council member has the opportunity to think of his or her own ideas for bettering Kenwood Station. And then, later on, they get to see their ideas go into action. I'm pretty sure my fellow volunteers will agree with me that it has been a joy to see our student council ideas make a positive difference in the school. With that, I leave you with a funny quote about volunteering. Remember, professionals built the Titanic. It was volunteers who built the Ark.
Oh yeah, good job, Reese.
I'd like to quickly recognize all student council members and volunteers, teachers that have helped throughout the school year. If you could all stand up, please.
Indeed.
That really concludes our presentation. I'd just like to say that these students have been working on these speeches for a few weeks now. It's pretty much been on their own. Some of them, this was the first day I heard them about an hour ago when we were practicing and stuff, and I think they've really done a great job of really putting into words what I probably couldn't have about what student council's done for this school, and I think it's just great to hear it from them rather than from me, and I think they've done a much better job of articulating it than I ever could.
Absolutely. It's a student showcase, Mr. Arledge, and we love that. Thank you, and I want to thank both sponsors very much and all of our student leaders at Kenwood Elementary. Questions or comments, board members?
Where's Ms. Alexis? When we first got here, there were several of us who talked to Mr. Morris about how nice the building looked. For being 9 years old, it looks really great, but he didn't tell us that he had all these little numbers. Good job, thank you.
Mr. Woosley was going to try to recruit you to go work at the Woosley Home a couple of days and make Alexis. He's looking for some kid janitors. Are there other serious questions or comments, board members? It was a fabulous showcase. I hope everybody enjoyed and learned as much as we did. Leadership is indeed one of our key attributes that we hope that every student leaves Oldham County with, and these students are well on their way. Thank you so much.
Thank you.